The crowd is amped up, ready to get this season underway, as are we. Back with more in a minute. And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Opening day baseball on the show. It's the Kansas City Royals and the Detroit Tigers. With my partner Chris Singleton, I'm John Schaub. So the Detroit Tigers find themselves as underdogs as the curtain rises on the season. Singy, what do you say in the clubhouse when a lot of folks are writing you off before the first pitch is even thrown?
You say forget all that, boo. Block out the noise because the season is decided on the field, okay? So there's still talent on this roster, and if one or two players have big years, they could be right in the thick of the race.
That's a good point, Chris. Seems like every year we see at least one team unexpectedly make a run, and maybe this season they could be that team. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So, almost ready to get underway, and today's starting pitcher, Eric Skubal.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
And to the plate for Kansas City, Bobby Witt Jr. The wind of the pitch. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. The 0-1.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some guys.
0-2 now.
One ball, two strikes.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Swings through it for the K. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound, because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
Yeah, the lefty with the 0-1. Out front and foul to the left side. Next one off the plate inside, and that is ball one. And the 1-2 misses to even the count.
Two balls, two strikes.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. And now it's filled up. Battling here as he fouls it away. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Liner, base hit.
Just a great at bat right there. Saw a lot of pitches. Got a change up and a pretty good one too. Outside corner, but he just got extended and put the barrel on it. Shody has a lot of plate coverage on that swing right there. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Ian Happ up to hit. Going one.
Happ, a switch hitter. It can be challenging for guys at the big league level to maintain a good swing from both sides of the plate. Clearly, he's got more pop from the left side, but in 2022, the right side was respectable as well.
Over to first, and he's safe. Eaton, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Next offering is in for a strike.
Double play situation here. He's been working up in the zone. Typically, you look for guys to get that ground ball. See if he adjusts on this next pitch.
It's softly on the ground left side. Now the throw to first on the run. Oh, the throw is wild. And he's going to make it up to second base, as that's a two-base error. He scores all the way from first. So just a brutal throwing error that time.
Errors that allow a run to score are always tough to stomach. But, man, it's extra frustrating when that runner comes all the way around from first base. Wasn't even in scoring position to start the play.
One out, runner at second. And now it's Salvador Perez to the plate. That one misses, and it's 1-0.
Count 1-0.
Runner leads away at second. Just missed.
They've got him working a little harder in this first frame than he anticipated.
And 2-0 is in for a strike. Good eye in that spot. Runner at second here, one gone. There's a swing and a drive. That's back there. Gone! His first homer of the year, and they boost their lead. It's 3-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
And it's Rhys Hoskins up to the dish. Hoskins pushes it foul.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button. Well, he's realizing out there on the mound that he's got to settle in pretty quickly, or else he's going to get hit hard in this first inning.
And 1-2. Still only one out here in the inning. Got it. Now 2-0. Drew Waters stands in. On the ground to third. Throw on to Torkelson. And that is that. Two-run shot for the Royals this inning. It's now 3-0. Back here in Detroit, today's starting pitcher, Brady Singer. What do we have on him?
Yeah, ZRA last year was a little worse than average, so definitely be looking for better results this season. One of the keys is just being able to have a consistent delivery and to be able to repeat that delivery so you can hit the spots that you want to hit and have a higher chance of being successful.
Akil Baddoo in the box now. No balls and a strike. Towards first. He takes it on his own. One up, one down.
Batting second.
Let's take a check of the Tigers lineup. They're dealing with a sinker specialist on the mound, which can be a big-time challenge when he's right and working mostly from the knees down.
Well, I think the approach you take is really try to lay off of those pitches down in the zone until he gets some called strikes and then forces you to go after that pitch. Until then, make him elevated, because guys that throw those sinkers, those two-seamers, really hard for them to be effective up in the zone. Those are pitches you can hammer, and when you get a cookie, you don't want to miss it.
And here it comes. Pitch is in there, and it's 2-1 now. Righty to the plate, and it's filled up. Popped up left side, makes the catch for the out.
Batting third, the second baseman.
Two outs, base is empty. Jonathan Schoop up now for the Tigers. In there for strike one. Swing and a miss. The 0-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And the 0-2. Good eye right there. And the slider just misses.
It's a good take.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Three up, three down for him there. We move on to the second here at Comerica. It's the Royals 3 and the Tigers nothing. Second inning set to go. So up now for Kansas City, Harrison Bader. Skubal back to work. And that's in for a strike. And that's downed away.
Tough to take a two-strike changeup that just missed. I think it froze him.
In the air, right side. Meadows should have it. And there's one away.
Batting it, the right fielder, Henry.
And here is Henry Ramos. A switch hitter batting right. That one's in there, 0-1.
Backdoored him with the breaking ball. Just got the corner. There's nothing you can really do with that.
Here's a rocket out to left. Badu puts it away. Two down.
Batting nine, the second baseman.
Nick Ahmed here to hit. And first offering is fouled off. The wind and the pitch. Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. Royals bats are quiet there, but they lead it 3-0. Bottom half of inning number two, leading off, Brandon Belt. Brandon Belt, who grew up in Texas, played his college ball at the University of Texas and then went on to win World Series with the Giants in 2012 and 2014. They called him the captain for a couple of years.
Yeah, and I remember Bruce Bochy talking about Brandon Belt when he was just coming up to the big leagues. He said he was a left-handed Buster Posey.
Now it's Javier Baez. And first offering is fouled off. Bounce to the right. Throws to first. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two.
The right fielder.
Two outs, base is empty. Austin Meadows up now for the Tigers.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Left-hand batter waits. And there's a foul ball. On and miss, struck him out, and good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Three up, three down for Detroit. They trail in this one 3-0. Top half of the third inning, here's a speed threat, Bobby Witt Jr. Scooble back to work. Bobby Witt Jr., a second generation big leaguer. His dad won 142 games in the show. The Royals made Bobby Jr. the number two overall pick in the 2019 draft right after Adley Rutschman, and he made his debut in 2022. Finished behind Julio Rodriguez, Rutschman, and Stephen Kwan for Rookie of the Year. Great crop of rookies.
Now batting, the third baseman.
Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Now here is Nate Eaton on the corner for a strike. It's 0-1. Witt gets his lead at first with nobody out. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out. Now here is Ian Happ. He's 0-1. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. And now the lefty, tap to first, Torkelson. Fires to second for one, over to first, but it's offline.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there, just rolled over it, got ground ball.
Salvador Perez steps in for the Royals. He's already homered in this game. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. In to score is the runner from third, and it's 4-0.
First pitch swing in, went up there with a plan to be aggressive. Got the top of the ball a little bit, but not much. That was hit pretty hard through the infield, so I think he'll be happy with that swing. Definitely generated some good bat speed.
So first and second with one man gone. Rhys Hoskins steps in for the Royals. 0-1, he struck out swinging last time. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Runners at first and second with one gone. Just a slow ground ball this time. On to scope. And that's two. So they get one run on three hits, no errors, and one left. We head down to the home half of inning number three. It's the Royals 4 and the Tigers nothing. Back at Comerica Park. Now at the plate, Nick Maton.
The third baseman.
Maton measures 6 feet, 2 inches, 180 pounds, and he was drafted in the seventh round back in 2017. The 0-1. And that one moves his feet. Fouls it off, still 1-2. And a pitch. The punch out there, one gone here.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Here's Mario Feliciano. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Feliciano getting the start at catcher, 25 years old, and he was born in Puerto Rico. Base knock right field. Runner on at first with one gone. And now the first baseman, Spencer Torkelson. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Tries to make the play, but it's foul. The pitch. Strike two.
Real ugly 0-1 swing right there. As a pitcher, got to be hunting for that strikeout. Keep him off balance. Send him back to the dugout.
The next pitch misses. Ball one.
One ball, two strikes.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And down on strikes he goes. And there's two away. Back to the top of the lineup, Akil Badu. Now at the plate, 0-1. He grounded out to first his last time. Strike one.
0-1's the count.
Feliciano off of first with two away. And two now, and the pitch is outside. Ball one. That one missed. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. One left for Detroit. They trail it here 4-0. Back here at the ballpark, out of the fourth. So here's the Royals DH, Drew Waters. The why to kick the pitch. That's in there. 0-1.
Well, these Royals doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at bats out of them. Pitch count is pretty high, and they've plated 4 runs already. So I think it's safe to say their game plan is working out pretty well right now.
Next offering is in for a strike.
So they forced the starter to put in a lot of work, and they've been able to get to him for some runs. And hopefully that bullpen phone is working today.
Swings and misses. He swung over top of the curveball. And now Bader up to the plate. 0 for 1. He flat out to right in his first trip. Oh and two as he waves at that one.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
And takes low for ball one. One down, base is empty. Good job to fight that one off. Way inside, gets out of the way. Next pitch misses. 3-2 now. And there's ball four.
It's not easy laying off that pitch. It's designed to fool you, but he just wasn't fooled at all.
Henry. And next up for the Royals, Henry Ramos. 0 for 1 so far. In there, and it's 0-1.
0-1's the count.
Swings through that one.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
Strike three. Got him looking on the changeup. Nick Ahmed digs in now. He's 0 for 1. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. And that is that. So one left for Kansas City, but they lead it 4-0. And welcome back. Here's Riley Green.
Taken high in the draft, he's had that top prospect label over him since he put on a professional uniform. But at some point, that starts to go away, and you've got to produce at the big league level.
And a pitch. And that one off the outside edge.
Well, these Tigers, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. So many of their outs have come from weak contact on pitches they're chasing outside of the strike zone. You can't do much of anything with those locations, and that's been true again today.
Next pitch misses outside, and a count 2-1.
And as a pitcher, when the hitters are swinging at everything, you feel no need to challenge inside the zone. You just keep working the corners and expanding that strike zone and beyond, and they just keep eating right out of your hand.
Next pitch off the play, and that's ball three. Bounce that off to the left, and we'll do it again. And a 3-2. Liner, and that should be extra bases. Now he'll turn for second. And he pulls in with a double for his first hit of the year.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
And now it's Jonathan Schoop. Struck out swinging his first time. Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and hard the order coming up right behind them. This is where they need to get going.
That just misses. One ball, one strike. Runner at second, nobody out. Hard ground ball, base knock. And they get it in quickly. First and third now with nobody out.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Didn't make quality contact on the ground ball to the pole side, but sometimes it's just a matter of finding a hole in the defense. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
Up to the plate, it's Brandon Belt. Tap dances out of the way of that one. No outs. Runners at first and third. The next offering misses, and it's 2-1.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
The 2-1. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. And another ball. Three and two. Payoff pitch. That one blasted deep to right. That's back. And that one's gone. Brandon Belt goes deep. His first homer of the year. And they cut into the lead. It's 4-3. Well, that swing changes things.
Yes, it does. They were in striking distance. They found a way to fight back big time. Hitter in a 3-2 count. He tried to challenge him, but just didn't have enough to get it by him. Really good swing and a nice home run.
The batter now, Javier Baez. Grounded out his first time. There's a strike.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Two pretty nasty sliders to get this hitter in an 0-2 count. If you're up there at the plate, you got to look up in the zone and spit on anything that's down.
In the dirt. Gathers and throws to first. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
We'll take a look at the three-pitch sequence here. Pretty simple in terms of putting them away at the plate. Once you're ahead 0-2 as a pitcher, you can really expand the zone and see how aggressive that hitter is going to be trying to protect and battle. And right there, clearly he was in swing mode, but all you can do is hope to foul that off.
Meadows, the batter now, as he swings and misses for strike one. He struck out swinging at his first at-bat. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. And that one almost got him. And a 1-2. Inside, and it hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
As a hitter, I'll take that all day long. An off-speed pitch, it's not going to rattle your cage too much.
And first offering is fouled off. Meadows leads off first with one away. Next offering misses, and the count is 1-1.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
So now 1-2
with two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
That misses, and it's 2-2. And that's outside. Mario Feliciano waits on deck. Here comes a 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, a breaking ball on that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
2-1 out. Now it's going to be Mario Feliciano.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
That misses, and that's ball one.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
Next one misses, and that's ball two.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, you're going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
The pitch, and a swing and a miss. In the air, center field. Bader makes the play. Two down.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
And next up for the Tigers, Spencer Torkelson. Swings through that one. 0-1. Bullpen action for the Royals. Chris Bubich up and loosening in the pen. First and second, two down. And it's 1-1. Pitch. Swing and a miss, and that is that.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Welcome back. We go to the top of the fifth. Now here's Bobby Witt Jr.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
First pitch just misses.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So that's a good take by him.
Next offering is in for a strike. Swings and misses at the pitch off the plate. That one off the mark, and the count's even at two. Good eye right there. Kicks and fires. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Right side, and foul ball.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball, and the hitter doesn't know what's coming next.
Struck him out looking.
Really good battle right there. And that final pitch probably could have gone either way. He was hoping he'd get ball four. Instead, the umpire rings him up for the backwards K.
Nate Eaton steps in for the Royals. To third, Maton. Zips it to first. And that quickly, two away.
The left fielder, number 8. Ian Happ.
Stepping in, Ian Happ, the Happ Daddy. Slice to right, and that's down, a base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Well, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Perez in the box here lets that one go for a ball. He's already homered here in this one. Hat off of first with two away.
Steal.
The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. There's a ball. Throw. Save.
When your catcher's not a great thrower, you have to do a better job at controlling the running game. And that's throwing over, that's stepping off, doing whatever you can to try to keep that base stealer's rhythm off. Well, they weren't able to do it right there. They're going to have to make some type of adjustment, or guys are going to be running all game.
Now a screamer into the outfield. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. Runner from second crosses the plate. It's 5-3, and in its second with an RBI double. And his hot hitting continues.
They kept him in the yard that time, but all he's doing now is passing the baton, and everything seems to get started around this guy.
And the batter now is Rhys Hoskins. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. First offering, and it just misses.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. Kind of shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
There's a strike. And there's a ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Next offering is down low.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience, not going outside the strike zone.
And now the count filled up 3-2. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
On the mound now, Will Vest. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Waters up for the third time here. Watches that one miss. Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. Checks his swing. Appeal down to third. And he won around. Ruled a swing. Righty delivers. And now 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
Next offering is outside. Two on, two outs. That's inside.
He wanted that fastball high and tight, looking for a strikeout, just didn't locate it very well.
Harrison Bader up next. That's to third. Throw on to Torkelson. They limit the damage here. KC gets one on the double. It's now a 5-3 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here in Detroit, we head to the bottom of the fifth. And here's the Tiger leadoff man, Akil Badu. And a pitch. In the air to left, down the line. Happ heads towards it. One away.
the batter, the center fielder.
And next to hit for Detroit, Riley Green. And ball one. So two balls and no strikes. And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball makes the count 2-1. Kicks and deals. Ripped to first, caught. Chris Bubich into the game.
At this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Jonathan Schoop up now for the Tigers, 1-2. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
This guy's usually not one to chase pitches off the plate, but he did there. We'll see if he can tighten up his zone a little bit.
Next pitch misses, and that's ball one.
You want to be patient here. Try to work a walk if you can. You've got a big power bat behind you in the on-deck circle, and with two outs, one swing can put you right back in this ball game.
Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two. Goes down looking for the strikeout. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees. Down in order go the Tigers. Still a two-run deficit. It's 5-3. Back at Comerica Park, top of the sixth inning. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Harrison Bader. The pitch. Just missed. Vest, a 6-foot righty. He features a 4-seam fastball, a slider, a changeup, and he works in a sinker. Swings through that.
1-1.
Gonna count 1-2.
Wow.
One ball.
Good luck catching up to that one.
And a ball and two strikes. Nope. And that just misses.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And the pitch stays alive. Right-handed reliever. In the air, left field, Badu moving under it. Makes the grab, and there's one down.
The right fielder, number 12.
Digging Henry. In is the switch inning outfielder, Ramos. Henry Ramos.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. And there's a strike. At the belt and fires.
Ball. Damn.
And there's a strike. One out to right. Meadows going after it. And it's caught for the out.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Now couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Nick Ahmed.
Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the second baseman, Nick Ahmed. Ahmed, a multi-gold glove award winner, 34-year-old vet. And he was a second round pick back in 2011. Two outs. Swing and a miss, and he got him to chase. And 1-2.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Next offering is in the dirt.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
The 2-2. Fights it off. He'll see another. Here comes a pitch. And now it's filled up.
Wow, this guy's really battling up there as if his run is the game-winning run. I love his tenacity.
Two down, nobody on. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Badu right there to make the grab. And that's the third out. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Royals 5 and the Tigers 3. Next will be the Tiger cleanup hitter, Brandon Bell. He really made his presence felt back in the fourth inning of this one, Singy.
Absolutely. Three-run blast and a shot of energy for his teammates. Everyone in that dugout was pretty fired up.
And a pitch. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Hap moving under it. Hauls it in for the out.
Up next to the Tigers, the shortstop,
Javier Baez, up now for the Tigers. That misses the zone, and that is ball one. Activity in the Kansas City bullpen. Aroldis Chapman, the veteran southpaw, is getting ready to come on if needed. The pitch. Swings and misses, and it's 1-1.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
The lefty ready, and a 1-1. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Pitch misses, and it's 2-2. And here it comes. Got him. Out number two.
Now batting right here.
Now it's Austin Meadows. First offering misses the mark. There's a strike. Swing and a ball popped up. Ahmed pulls that one down, and that'll do it. So they go quietly there. We're through six full. It's the Royals 5 and the Tigers 3. Jason Foley on a pitch out of the pen here. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Here's the shortstop at the plate. Bobby Witt Jr., 1-for-3. The pitch. This one chopped on the ground, but foul.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Back to the mound, into the outfield, base hit.
Now batting.
Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Next to him, Nate Eaton. That's in there. That's strike one. Witt gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Strike two.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
He goes down looking. Ian Happ steps in for the Royals.
Showed a really nice opposite field approach in his last at bat.
Runner on the go. And first offering is fouled off. Pickoff throw. Witt dives back in safely. The 0-1. Foul ball. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Well, interesting. He's looking very comfortable out of the stretch after giving up the leadoff single. Back-to-back strikeouts, so they haven't been able to move that runner up, get him into scoring position, and try to have a better chance of scoring. I tell you, good job so far on the mound. He just needs one more out.
Next is the Royals catcher, Salvador Perez. And it was a homer back in the first inning that got his day started at the plate.
Yeah, Boog, a two-run blast as fans were just still getting into their seats here at the ballpark. So if you showed up late to this one, you missed out on a big moment early on.
Bounced up the middle. Slings to first, and they get Perez for the out. Third out. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one left. Seventh inning stretch time. It's the Royals 5 and the Tigers 3. And welcome back. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now the third baseman, Nick Maton. Bubic back to work. That one finds the zone, and it's 0-1. And a swing and a miss. Ground ball right side. Fires over to Hoskins, and a quick out number one. And here's the catcher, Mario Feliciano. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Sliced hard, but foul. The 1-1. This to center field. Bader should have it. And there's two away.
Now batting, the first baseman.
So digging in, Spencer Torkelson. Fastball right back to the mound. The throw to first, and they get Torkelson for the out. Inning over. Nothing doing for the offense that time. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Royals 5 and the Tigers 3.
We're at the top of the eighth, and here's the first baseman, Rhys Hoskins.
Number 17, Rhys Hoskins.
The pitch. Just off the outside edge. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Here's a 1-1. And that one lifted in the air center field. Hauls it in, and there's one away.
The batter, number 6.
And to the plate for Kansas City, Drew Waters. Check swing of the first pitch. Look down to third. Nope, he held back. The 1-0.
Ball two.
Swings through that one for strike one.
It might be time to choke up a little bit. Get that front foot down early. Maybe even just spread out. He's really late right now.
Way out front for strike two.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Next pitch is inside. And the count's full.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Check swing. Tried to hold up. Now an appeal to third. No swing. That's ball four. He walked him.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Here's the center fielder, Harrison Bader. Alex Lang gets the call from the pen.
Just trying to keep this one close here. And this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
Ball one, no strikes. Waters leads off first with one away. And there's the strike.
1-1.
On the ground to first, could be two. Over to second for one. Out. Return throw to first, got him. Double play, and that'll do it. Nothing doing here this half. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the Royals 5 and the Tigers 3. So the Royals bring on a new arm, Josh Taylor.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Now the left fielder, Akil Badu.
The left fielder, Akil Badu.
Pinch hitter coming on, Matt Vierling. And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, these Tigers, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. They've hit 7 line drives already, and even though some of them have been for outs, there's nothing wrong with delivering consistent hard contact. That's almost always going to lead to positive results.
Here's the 0-2.
That's a ball. 1-2.
Foul ball left side. He'll see another. And now the lefty. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Now batting, center fielder.
So up next, Riley Green.
strike one. Lefty continues to work, but the closer getting loose of the bullpen. Step off, throw to first. Veerling gets back easily. Another throw over. And they're keeping him close. Pitch misses, and the count even 1-1.
Good speed on the base paths. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
The tying run at the plate. There's a swing and a miss.
Going to really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
Runner at first with no outs here. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Struck him out looking. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three.
Well, big strikeout right there, and maybe a little controversial with the call. I think he got a little bit of favor on the mound, no question about it. It's not exactly what you want to see in a big spot like that, and I'm sure there's some chirping going on from the dugout, making it clear that wasn't his best call behind the plate today.
So digging in, Jonathan Schoop. That one ran inside, almost got him.
Straightened him up a little bit.
Snap throw to first. And he's back standing. Down the line, and it's foul.
Well, they say it's a game of inches, and that's a perfect example right there. Could have been a big swing in this game if it stayed fair.
Step off throw to first. Veerling back in standing. And he deals. That one misses, and it's 2-1.
2-1 the count now. He hasn't seen a fastball yet, but you've got to be ready to hit one because you doubt the pitcher wants this to go to a 3-1 count.
Swing, and oh, the bat went flying there. Strike three, got him swinging. And there's two away.
No need to deviate from the slider right there. The hitter just not making the adjustment. He came at him with the breaking ball, pitch after pitch in that at bat, and evidently there was no answer for it.
And next is the designated hitter, Brandon Bell. First offering misses badly for ball one. Veerling, the runner at first with two gone. Got it started a little too early. Strike one.
That pitch started in and ended up on the outside edge. Just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
Not even close there. And a count 2-1.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
The 2-1. Next offering misses down and away. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
And it's filled up.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
3-2 on the way. And the tying run is on base.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
New pitcher in the game for the Royals, Josh Stamont.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
So two on with two away. And up next for Detroit, Javier Baez. Ripped, but it curls foul. Right-hander kicks, deals. Now one and one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Scott Barlow getting loose out there. Falling behind 2-1.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Swing and a miss. That is strike two. And the righty deals. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Righty delivers. And now it's filled up. So both runners should be on the move here on the full count pitch.
Yeah, this is a good chance to tie up this ball game. See if he can find some open grass in the outfield.
3-2. And they're all loaded up.
Pretty much the last thing you want from your bullpen arms are free passes, especially in spots like this. Make the team earn their way out.
Now it's Austin Meadows.
Well, this is a critical spot for both the pitcher and the hitter. You can learn a lot about a guy by how he handles these pressure situations.
The 1-1.
In situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Can't connect on the curveball, struck him out.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
So remaining in the game defensively, Matt Vierling. He'll be the new left fielder after entering the game as a pinch hitter. So digging in, Henry Ramos. The wind and the pitch. 0-1. The wind of the pitch. That takes low for ball one. Goes down looking. Nick Ahmed will hit next. Ball one there. Fouled off down the right side. Here's a 1-1.
Nope. 2 balls, 1 strike.
That clips the corner. In the air, right field. Meadows makes the catch, and there's two away.
Now that the shortstop,
Bobby Witt Jr. steps in for the Royals. Singh, you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays. There's the strike.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-2.
Been a solid inning so far in relief. Getting through this inning only down two can give their lineup a real opportunity to just grind their way back into this game with the few outs that they have left.
Line drive, base hit, right field.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Eaton, the next to hit, takes ball one. Witt leads off first with two down to the inning. Line to right, and that'll be a base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Back-to-back base hits. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Hap stands in with two away as he takes a ball.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
The next offering misses. Now 2-0.
He's getting a little frustrated out there on the mound, getting hit around a little bit. Let's see if he can settle himself down.
That misses. Three balls, no strikes. Salvador Perez would be next if they can extend the inning.
And he's homered already, so I'm sure he'd love a chance to do some more damage here.
Strike on the inside corner. And it's 3-1. And that'll load the bases.
A real bad time for a walk. You're trailing in this ballgame, trying to keep things close. They've been in a difficult spot, and things aren't getting any easier.
Two outs, bases loaded. Now it'll be the cleanup hitter for the Royals, Salvador Perez. Trevor Rosenthal taking over on the mound.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
Ball one low.
Kind of goes without saying, but stranding these two runners in scoring position right here, it feels like it's a must if they stand a chance to win this game.
Line drive, that's a base hit. One runs in, a second scores as well. Three runs are in, and the lead is up to five.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. He got a pitch he could drive, but he didn't get too excited like a lot of guys do and pull off the baseball. Really good timing all the way through the swing, and the barrel was so on plane with the ball. Easy drive into the gap for that double.
And now here is Rhys Hoskins. Righty to the plate. They say it went.
1-1.
That misses the zone, and it's 2-1. Runner at second, two down. That one down the line, and that's just foul. Two now. Slider misses outside. In the air, right field. Fair ball. Here comes Perez around third. He'll score easily, and it's 9-3. To second, pulls him off the bag.
When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often, but right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
Waters in the box with two gone, and takes a look at a called strike. Right side, hard hit. Tosses to first. That's the third out. So four runs on four hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Bottom part of the order, 7-8-9, two up in inning number 9. Royals 9 and the Tigers 3. All set for the bottom of the 9th. And now, Nick Maton. Stamont back to work. Just off the outside part of the plate. Action in the pen down there. Taylor Clark up and throwing. And it's even up.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2. Maton tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. Did not go. Lined into left center. Base hit.
He was all over that one. Just a really nice approach to shoot that line drive to the opposite field. There's a lot of hard work and discipline that goes into getting a result like that at the plate. Doesn't come naturally for most hitters.
Feliciano, the next to hit, takes ball one. Maton on at first, nobody out.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Next offering upstairs. This to third. The throw to second is offline.
Thanks, he's good.
Up next. Unfortunately, they've got a big lead on the scoreboard, so that error shouldn't hurt too much. But you have to be careful about losing concentration in a game like this. It can be an easy trap to fall into.
So up next, Spencer Torkelson. He swings and fouls one off. And the right-hander deals. Ball. Off the mark there. And the count is 1-1. In the dirt, but kept close. No movement on the bases. 1-2 the count. The pitch. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Good eye right there.
And a payoff pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
New pitcher on now, Taylor Clark.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Back to the top of the Detroit order. And now it's going to be Matt Wierling. Out to center. Bader sizing it up. Makes the grab on the run. And there's one down. And here is Riley Green.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And that's in there for strike one.
Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
Next offering misses. 1-1. And now the count 1-2 after the swing and the miss. Got it by him for the K.
Man, that slider bearing in on your hands like that, it's just so tough to fight off. It's kind of like a cutter and just can eat you up, saw you off. Tell you what, hitters have nightmares about that pitch. Perfectly executed out there on the mound.
That one hit to right. Ramos in position. And that'll do it. The Royals take the season opener and move to 1-0.
It's always nice to grab the opener of a series. You come into a new ballpark and just sometimes things aren't as comfortable as what you've been used to. The mound doesn't look straight. The background isn't what you like, but they didn't let any of those things distract them. In fact, they looked like they were playing a home game. Excellent job to set the tone for this series.
9-3, your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi saying so long.
Our final life score this afternoon. First.